لك والملك لا شريك لك.
لبيك اللهم لبيك،
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك.
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
لبيك اللهم لبيك،
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك.
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
لبيك اللهم لبيك،
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك.
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك.
لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك.
It's supposed to, I can't stop smiling. I'm not even trying. My eagerness is rising. But the best 3 days is now upon us. Immersed in His blessings, Allah grants protection. He protects us. I'm so thankful.
Apollo 11 on a proper heading. There's a place on earth where prayer never ceases. People have been worshiping throughout all time. There to please their maker, that's the only reason. It's a place of gathering for all mankind. Take me to the Kaaba, I must go there. If I ever lose in my lifetime, let me see the nations gathering there, worshiping Allah, the Lord Divine. Take me to the Kaaba, Lord, give me the means to find my way there. Take me to the Kaaba, I must go there in my lifetime. Take me to the Kaaba, Lord, give me the means to find my way there. Take me to the Kaaba, I must go there in my lifetime. Take me to the Kaaba, Lord, give me the means to find my way there. Take me to the Kaaba.
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا
اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
لبيك اللهم لبيك
لبيك
لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك
والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. عيد مبارك. تقبل الله ومنه ومنكم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our good deeds throughout this blessed time, this wonderful occasion. Eid is such a special moment in all of our lives, and it should be, and this is a day of celebration. So I sincerely, on behalf of myself and my family, I wish all of you a special Eid Mubarak. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all your good deeds throughout the the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Arafah. And you know, Muslim Network TV has been doing a fantastic job trying to connect everyone virtually in a time when unfortunately many of us have been disconnected from the masajid, from Islamic learning, and so on and so forth. So Muslim Network TV is your new hub, your new home for Islamic content, entertainment, educational, informational, and everything in between. We're here broadcasting actually live today on this wonderful occasion of Eid. And it's a day that genuinely I'm so excited and happy about, because I know it's a day that, you know, when I was young, we always used to look forward to. Many of us, we get excited, especially the kids. They get their presents. They get my kids, mashallah, tabarakallah. I don't think they even brush their teeth. They just go straight to the candy. Allahu Akbar, right? That's what we do on this day. It's a day of spoiling our kids for them to feel the beauty of our religion and our faith. And it's a reality, especially for Muslims who live in the West, that especially on days like this, we should make a point of celebration and showing our young people, showing our community and families how much this day means to us. Because of course, when you know we see different holidays and we see the way society treats those holidays with so much exuberance and so much, you know, showcase and TV shows, and you know, when the holiday season comes around, of course, that's something that everyone would look forward to in that side of the world. So we need to, especially as Muslims living in this part of the world, use Eid as an occasion to celebrate and proclaim our love of this deen and to show the rest of the world how much this day means to us, including our children. So Eid Mubarak. Make sure you spoil your kids for these next few days. Allow them to eat all the candy they want, inshallah. It's an advice from me, okay? Make sure they feel happy and joyous in these occasions. Of course, visit your family. Do the things that you can. And let's also try our best to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these times. Many people, especially after Eid al-Fitr, you know, after a month of fasting, people sometimes go back to their, you know, old ways or do things that they, you know, perhaps shouldn't have been doing. But let us use this as an occasion to remember the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember the sacrifice that our father Ibrahim alayhi salam made for us, right? This is a beautiful time because, you know, many times in Islamic history, we don't just talk about things that happened in the past. We relive those enactments. We relive those historical moments. And that's why you have the Safa and Marwa, you have the sacrifice of Hajar, you have the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and all the things that he did. And that's why we do the Qurbani and the Udhiyah and these things, to replicate and to show people in real life, you know, how these things would have been played out. So it's an honor for me to be hosting this day's program. My name is Bona Muhammad. For those of you who don't know me, I'm one of the presenters on Muslim Network TV. I actually host a show called Art to Heart, which is combining art, poetry, spoken word, rap, nasheed, and all the work that comes from our Muslim community and has, you know, this spiritual aspect to it. I try and showcase that on my show. So if you haven't tuned in to my show, make sure you do so, inshallah, on Muslim Network TV. And of course, there is great content all throughout the channel and broadcasting live every day, every single day of the week, many different programs, many, you know, amazing types of content. You can check us out on YouTube, on Facebook, on Instagram, all those good social media networks, inshallah, we're there as well. Today, again, is a special day. And somebody also pointed out that I was part of the classic Adam's World episode. The saw this for Salah, yeah, the Mr. Adhan. I was Mr. Adhan, for those kids who out there who don't know me. I was the guy who's making the Adhan. Hey, Alal Falah, hey, Alal Salah, right? That was me. And I was doing it with Adam. Adam, he was showing me the ropes. He was showing me how to get my Adhan game down properly. So I'm excited. I know a lot of you are tuned in online live. If you are watching this program live through YouTube or through Zoom or wherever, you know, you are watching it live, make sure to comment in the comment box. We want to hear from you all. For some performers, it's difficult. Typically speaking, you know, when you have an audience, you have people who are going to be receptive to you. It's a little bit easier sometimes to, you know, feel the crowd out and get hyped and energized. So unfortunately, of course, you know, we cannot see you all, but at least we can hear from you through your messagings and your words of encouragement for myself and the other performers. So please, inshallah, make sure you comment as much as you can through the text box if you're watching through Zoom, or of course through the YouTube live comments. We have a packed program today. I'm excited to present the, you know, really we tried to touch on kind of every single aspect of art in its many different genres. We have myself who will be doing some spoken word poetry. We have two wonderful sisters who will be doing a children's program coming up very shortly. And we have my two good friends and brothers, Sayed and Omar Reagan, who are going to be doing nasheed and comedy respectively. So if you know, have heard of those names and you're looking forward to it, please make sure you share this link with your friends and family on social media. Let's get this party started. Let's make sure that everybody tunes in and joins in for this wonderful program. It's a day of Eid. It's still the day of Eid. You know, some of you prayed yesterday, but remember the day of Eid is actually 3 days. So we're still in the day of Eid, still a time for a celebration and fun. So I hope all of you, inshallah, can keep that festive spirit up. And in doing so, I want to remember again that what we're doing here at Muslim Network TV is unique because we are trying to connect Muslims from all around the world. I know we have people who are watching from the UK, people who are watching from the US, from Canada, Australia, wherever you are, give us a shout out in the message box and let us know where you're watching live from. I know a lot of folks are watching from Chicago. If Chicago's in a building, make some noise, inshallah. If Toronto or Mississauga, anywhere else from my neck of the woods is watching, make sure you let us know as well. We want to hear from all of you. But this is what it's about, right? When you go to Hajj, when you see the multitudes of races and cultures and backgrounds, it makes you remember that this deen is something special, that it could bring people from every single walk of life, from the smallest village and tribe in Africa to the, you know, the royal families of the Arabias, or, you know, a small village in Indonesia. You know, when you go to Hajj, you get to see every single different shade, race, and it's beautiful. You know, for those of you who haven't gone, unfortunately this year, I don't think any of us were able to go. I had a beautiful chance of going for Hajj in 2012, and it, you know, really did change my life. So, you know, in that notion and spirit of togetherness and unity, I want to encourage all of you, inshallah, to spread this with your friends and family. And I'm going to get this party started off right, because I feel like I'm the master of ceremonies, the MC for today, and I need to set a good precedence and example for everyone to come after me. So I'm going to share with you a very special spoken word piece. This is a piece that I've performed around the world, and it's one that I'm really passionate about, because it's about this wondrous, beautiful deen of ours and the creator of all, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the signs that he sends for all of us, Hajj being one of them. The fact that you have that many people from around the world who are coming together, you know, this is something that could only be done by the creator of hearts and the one who brings our hearts together. So this is a piece I want to share with you all. It's called Signs. Let me just take a big drink of water because, you know, I got to stay hydrated. Let me take a moment to show some kindness to the folks who thought blindness was a disease that affected the eyes alone. I promise I won't judge you. I barely know how to love you, and like fools, we preach rules, but we don't even follow our own. Everybody needs comfort. Some people find it in this, some people find it in that, and some people just don't find it at all. But this world is full of signs, from the moon to the stars and the sky, from the bees and the bugs, like a seed in your blood, like a fiend who a drug makes you need to look up and question what's up, why you deal with this stuff when your spirits are crushed and you trek through the rough. But like thunder, it struck, said be, and it was all the signs that were sent. They finally make sense. You feel the torment, so you need to repent. When your heart is cement, it's hard as a brick, because your soul is worth more than the dollars and cents. All the money in the world couldn't buy you happiness, because verily it is in the remembrance of Allah that hearts do find rest. And do not get it confused, I'm not a scholar or a preacher, I'm just a regular dude who makes mistakes too, but we are reflections, true. So I can't talk about me without talking about you, and who knew we would end up in a place so confused, where little boys want to be like little girls and little girls just want to be abused, where they terrorize the truth, mentally arrest the youth, even though there is no law but Allah's, and mama didn't raise no fool. And who knew that expecting the world to treat you fairly because you think you're a good person would be a little like expecting a bull not to attack you because you're a vegetarian. You can't begin to learn what you think you already know. In man's own ignorance, we forgot that women once watched us grow. And before that, you were a tiny ball of flesh without any bones. And before that, you were just unknown. And now look, behold, you have the arrogance to assume that you just made it on your own. But what were you but a chewed piece of clot before you grew? And who knew you would trace your ancestries back to a zoo? You must have really come from apes with your monkey point of views. Even the devil believes in God. So what does that make you? And it's true. Sometimes I feel like Noah preaching to a packed empty room. Nobody want to listen until we start rolling out two by two. I'm a big fan of Abraham. Never break up from Jacob. Joseph had the kind of beauty that you couldn't find in makeup. Moses was to Pharaoh what stones are to arrows. And David to Goliath what truth is to silence. Following Solomon, I'd get down too. Contrary to popular belief, Jesus is my homeboy too. So peace be upon the whole crew. Came to teach what we never knew, even though few caught the groove. They never turned blue, never confused what was true, even if it was a taboo. Never came for fame or praise, but to praise who they prayed to. Who? And who knew that an unlettered man from the middle of the desert would change the whole world from darkness into heaven? You may have every title, every big shot degree, but you still can't explain Alif Lam Mim. Allahu Akbar. And who knew there would be so many views and ways to explain that he's closer to you than your jugular veins? So if you complain, well, God must be true. Can you give Allah all that he gives to you? From the breath that you breathe to the trees that you feed, from the eyes that you see to the sea that you eat. If I cut you, you bleed, then you heal magically. We're the illest machines manufactured for means. The concept's extreme, but this world is a dream. It's not what this seems, filled with lies and deceit. The proof is serene, so wake up, smell the dean. Praises be to he, his oneness supreme, totally unique, in no need of sleep, not like you or me, his greatness complete. No partners, no mates, no fathers, no sons, no discount three in one, just Allah Azza wa Jalla. Even the birds sing his name, the Lord of all the worlds. Glory be to he, and to Allah is our return.